All right, hey everybody, ding, 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 ding. Right, we've got breaking news here in the world of high school football, and this really just threw all of us aback. This was a bombshell, and this has never happened before. Tom Markowski is here to talk about the fact that King has forfeited the game against Cass Tech, the PSL championship game set to take place on Friday night. What is going on?
There's a lot of ramifications behind the scenes, but we can't get anybody to talk. At least I can't get some on record. But what we found out is there was a fight, a really brawl that took place after the Cody King game in the PSL semifinals last Friday. Now, it's hard to say who instigated it. It appears at this time that Cody may have started the fight that King got involved with, and we can't figure out yet if King actually forfeited that game on their own or if the PSL, the offices, Alvin Ward being the athletic director, came in and said, you're forfeiting this game. I am assuming it's going to be the latter, not the former. King, from what we could tell, was trying to avoid an altercation but was kind of drawn into this. And it takes two to tango, so you know there is much to blame as Cody is in this as the end result. Now the start of it may have been Cody's fault, but it really doesn't matter at this point. The bottom line is there is no big game at Ford Field that everybody was anticipating. The rematch of Cass and King, 31-28 overtime, King won the first one. The ramifications of this, you just think of thousands of dollars that the PSL is missing out here. Let's say $10 a ticket, which assume that's what it was,
right,
plus the parking that would go on into the city. You are not going to get a crowd for Detroit Central Collegiate Prep. That game has been moved from 4 to 6. You're going to get 100 fans for that or thereabouts.
Could be a good game, but it's just not a draw.
No, you got somebody like a Cass and a King that I was there for some of those games. There's 6,000-7,000 people. You multiply that by 10 and you can come up with a sizable check. This is money that PSL would have made. Ford Field, you know, is already bought and paid for, so the PSL is going to lose some money. Talking to the source I have, they've already paid for it. This is money that the PSL had made from previously that they saved up for this event to get Ford Field. So there are a lot of cash. And I think another loser here is the fans. Cass King, here's two teams that could win state championships. Let's be honest. King is very number one in the state. They can win D2.
Yep.
Cass Tech, in my mind, them and Saline are 1-2 and are running for a Division I title.
Absolutely. And what I don't understand is this is a great showcase for the public school league. It's like the basketball game that you have at Callahan. This is you know, the day you put on your nice suit, you know, and you show off the league.
Right. This is the baby you bring home.
Absolutely. This is where you have your, you know, there's someone that's phenomenal talent that's on display. This is everything that's good. Why would they, if things are the way it transpired that maybe they were coaxed into this brawl, if that's fair, why would the PSL punish King?
We can't figure that out. We're talking off camera a little bit about what, and I've left messages with King's coach Dale Harbell and trying to get with Thomas Wilcher at Cass Tech. See, I'm looking at Cass Tech too. I know they're the innocent bystanders here. They don't get to play on the field for this championship.
No.
Sure, you're forfeited. Here's your title, but it's an empty trophy because there's no game being played. But I don't understand why King was forced to do this unless they went over the line, so to speak. Okay, you're drawn into a fight, it becomes a brawl, and then you take action where you become the aggressor.
Right, you take control.
Right. We understand that Cody coaches are suspended indefinitely. There appears to be some altercation that took place immediately after the game between parents and the Cody coaches, and that might have escalated into the after effects of the brawl after the game, which we understand there was a lot of flags.
Where did this happen? Where did this brawl happen?
I believe the semifinals were played at King, which also brings in a factor. It's always.
Was this in the parking lot?
I'm sure it was on the field.
Okay.
And there is a parking lot that's right next to King. If you come into the entrance off of Lafayette, there's that small parking lot on the grass that they have public officials and media park in. That's gated.
Yeah.
So it could have taken place there. That makes sense because that's where a lot of the teams come in.
Right.
So, you know, it's such a really black eye on this and the city and the PSL, which, like you said, this is their showcase game. This is when they get to beat their chest and say, we're really good. We're holding it at Ford Field.
All right, well, as you can see, this is a fluid situation.
One ramification here is that King will now get a loss, you know, given a forfeit. That'll take away playoff points from them. They'll probably get home field advantage for at least the first round, maybe the second round, but it couldn't hurt them later on having to play on the road. Cass Tech gets a win for this. They'll be 8-1.
Wow, Tom, thanks. That's breaking news. If we get any other pertinent information, we'll bring it to you for sure. Thanks for watching.